रवि, योर वॉइस इज नॉट ऑडिबल.
His mic is off.
Now fine,
okay.
right? Now fine, na?
Yeah.
Now you are audible.
Yes.
Just only one thing, guys. Okay, without skills, right? No one can buy. Seeing the face, no one can give the money, guys. Okay. Just improve your skills. If you have the skills,
yes, Ravi.
If you have the skills, you know. In industry, think about that, the corona kind of situation, how many people becoming jobless now in this kind of situation? Who is the surviving the job? Whoever having the knowledge, whoever having the skills. And you guys are there in the right
yes,
place.
Sir.
You guys are there in the right place, guys. Why you are thinking about that? Just we are taking this kind of knowledge free and nothing. And even I'm providing those things on a YouTube channel also. I will
yes,
see
sir.
That. I will see that one miss the session in the next weekend onward. Okay, whoever missed the session, they will not found the video on YouTube channel. Okay, I will provide all those things as a driver. Drive.
Okay.
One minute. I want to see that the last time. Name, right? Name those things. I will remove those people if the people are joining me. Okay, I don't want those idiots in the session. Okay, no issue, guys. So last time we seen that Swagger, right? Swagger UI. And I hope after completing practical, you guys will become what? Little bit good in the Swagger, guys. Okay, so this is the code only we seen that. This code for the info on the UI, right? On the UI, Swagger UI. And this is the code to generating what? UI page related to Swagger now, guys. Okay. And this code is only what? One time setup. Okay. We have need to do what? Only one time in the project. And every time, whatever controllers and all those things we will write in the project, right? Everything will come, right? So we seen that at last time, right?
Yes. Yes, Ravi.
Yes, Ravi. Yes.
Okay,
yes,
fine. Sir. Okay, fine. Good.
Okay, yeah. So excuse me, sir. So what you're saying is so if we have this code in our application, we don't have to use Postman to test the endpoints.
Yes. Yes, to tell the endpoint information, right? Without Postman, just think about that thousands controllers are there. If one controller is there, we can test it, right? Every time by putting the URI and method, we can take based on that, right? But think about that thousands controllers are there, then it's horrible to test, right?
That's right.
So because of that,
exactly.
by using the Postman UI, right? By using the Postman UI, what we can do, every method, every controller information, it will scan. Even we don't have need to give inputs also, just we have need to pass the value. By passing the value, we can test it. Then what will happen? Our time will reduce or not?
Time will reduce, yeah.
Yes. So to testing Swagger also for the testing purpose only, to test our end point, guys. Okay. To test our end point for that purpose also Swagger only, right? Swagger also for that purpose only. So even using the Postman also, what we are doing, we are testing our end point. Nah, come on.
Yes,
that's
sir.
True, sir. Yeah, doing the same. Yes.
Yeah. So same things we are doing using Swagger also. Swagger also. Now, okay. So next one is what we are going to implement it now. Next, we are going to work on consumer application. Let's work on consumer application now, guys. Till now, this is the what? This is the producer application. Now we are making the request using Postman or Swagger and we are getting the response, but still we are not completed consumer. Come on, we have need to develop our consumer application also, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you only have to develop.
Who can consume our services, right? Okay,
right,
fine. So okay, so good. So 1 minute, I will make one more time the request, same request. Okay, http://localhost, this one, right? Yeah. two controllers are there. So see this, just we are making the request using this URL, guys. Okay, we are making the request using this URL, and all information about our endpoint, the what Swagger UI is scanned, and based on that what we are doing now, just we are making the request, just we have need to call it, right? Just we have need to call it. Or if you want to save the data, just click on the post, try it out, and here we are getting all model data information. We don't have need to write what explicitly, but using the postman, what we are doing, we are writing explicitly or not.
Yes,
so just what we are, see this here, what I'm doing now, just I'm removing this one, right? This thing's calculated by where it will calculate our application services. Itself, our application only, yes. Right? So here, yes, what we are, yeah, here what we are doing now, here just I'm writing mobile, and cost I'm just taking what 5,000 now. Just I'm getting what cost is what 5,000, right? 5,000, and provide a vendor, just I'm giving what, just vendor name is what, Samsung.pvt, right? Now what I'm doing now, just execute, click on the execute, see this, our what API is executed, and what three products are stored in the database. Come on, already why it's not taking first one, because we taken the what HBM to DDL, right? Update, we took what update. Property name as what update, because of this one what we are getting what third record, right? So in the database already which three records are there now,
yes sir.
See this, already three records are there in the database.
Two are there,
but one record number two we deleted, yes. Because of that it's a sequential order, right? ID is generating, right, so right. third record, right? So fine now, guys. Okay, so okay, similar same things, whatever things we are doing using what postman, but what we are doing in the postman, explicitly we are selecting the methodology as well as we are putting the what URL as well as what we are taking the what JSON data as well as what we only selecting what the media type, right? But what using postman, Swagger, what we are doing, just we are doing only one time coding in the right, in the what, in the application configuration, right, in the configuration class, and based on that what we are doing now using this URL, what we are doing, we are making the request, and all information about our endpoint, what will happen now, it will scan and it's giving the services to what use it now, guys. Okay, come on.
Right.
Okay, guys. So now this discussion is completed now, guys. Okay, so see this. See, Swagger, till now the discussion is completed, right? Till now the discussion is completed. Now we have need to move on what? Still, Swagger discussion is completed. No, unit testing is still no. Okay, UI integration plus what is that? We have need to using what is that REST template.
Yeah, yes, Ravi.
REST template, right? We have need to develop what our consumer application. Consumer application we have need, because till now we are completed what provider application, guys. Okay, see, based on that what postman client we are making the request, but which area we completed in the project, this area only, right? Come on.
Yes, sir.
And this application is nothing but what producer application, right?
Producer.
Yes, sir.
Okay, but someone is what consuming this application services also, right? So for that, using, if you want to develop our client application in the Java, using Java coding, for that purpose, what is that REST template is there, guys? Okay, REST template, right?
Can we develop Angular, Ravi, instead of REST template?
Yeah, we can develop it. Don't worry. I said that UI part, right? UI integration.
Okay, fine.
I will give the UI integration, right? But still focus on this area now, okay? Don't worry. If you are showing the curiosity, I will deliver all those things, guys, okay? But if you guys are showing the laziness, right? So I also becoming in the session lazy. Even my voice also, in my voice also, you guys can observe it, right? So fine now, guys. Okay, REST template is there, right? REST template. So let's develop our consumer application, guys. Okay, so just normally see this. Just normally, what is that? I said initial day only, right? Initial day only I explained, right? So what is that? Just this is the producer application. In the producer application, normally how many layers are there now, guys?
Three layers.
Application, right? In the producer application, right? In the producer application, what is that? In the producer application, three layers are there, right? What is that? Presentation layer, integration layer, right?
Sorry,
service layer and what?
Service layer.
Data access layer, right? So for that, to interact with what, where our application is interacting, but what is that? We are implementing REST endpoint also, right? For that purpose, we wrote what is that? We wrote what? Integration layer also, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so, okay, fine now, guys. So this is what? This is our what? This is the producer application, right? This is the producer application, but we have need, what is that? Just think about that. This application is what? Our product application, right? This application is what? Product management application. Product application, right? Just product application, but some clients are there. Who is the using our product application services now, guys? Okay, those people are using what? Our product services application. So for that, we have need to develop consumer also, right? Come on, but don't worry.
Yes,
in the real time, guys. Okay, only we are developing what? Consumer application. Nikhilesh Upadhyay, what happened? Okay, no issue. Okay. Yeah, integration layer, right? So, okay, so what, based on that what? See this, based on that what? Postman, we can make the different type of request, na? Come on, guys. Like get, post, put, patch, delete, right?
Yes,
so similar. So if you want to develop what our consumer application, if you want to develop our what consumer application, what we will do it now, guys, we will use the REST template now, guys. Okay, REST template having the capacity to make the different what request type, guys. Okay, we have need to what our REST template having the capability to make the different kind of request now, guys. Okay, so fine now, guys. Just think about that. This is our what? Consumer application. This is our what? Consumer application now. Consumer application, right? This is what? Our consumer application. We are developing our consumer application using what? We are developing our consumer application using what? REST template, right? Using what? REST template. This REST template is nothing but what? Class, guys. Okay, this REST template is nothing but what, guys? Class. Okay, in the Spring, right? So based on that REST template, what we can make what? Get type request, put type, post type request also, and put type request also, whatever methodology is there, HTTP methodology, we can use all those methodology based on that what REST template now, guys. Okay, so just think about that here. What will happen now? Our what? REST template will make what? REST client will make what? Request, right? Request to where now? Where our consumer application, or sorry, our producer application, using what? Using which protocol now, guys? HTTP protocol, right? Using what? HTTP yes. Protocol. So now what? Yeah, so our request will come to our producer application now, guys. Our request will come where now? In producer application. So here what will happen now? It will interact with our what? Integration layer. This request will interact with what? Our integration layer. Now, integration. Yes, integration layer. Now in the integration layer, what is that? REST controller is there now. Come on.
Yes, sir.
REST controller. REST controller, right? REST controller class is there.
Yes, sir.
REST controller class is there. After then, what will happen now? This integration layer, if need, right? Then this application in this producer application, our application will interact with service layer and it will return the business logic in the controller itself only, right? After then, the data will pack inside that in which object now, guys? In which object? Come on, response entity. Come on,
response entity object.
Good. Now so fine, now after then what will happen? We are getting that this response entity itself as what in to what we are getting the response entity object response. to whom yeah, our REST client, right? Our REST client,
we are getting, application.
Yeah, our REST client is nothing but what? Consumer application. That's now fine. Guys, okay, so similarly, just this one will become what? This one will become what? This application will become, just think about product vendor. Come on, guys.
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, yes. This is what our product vendor, right? So fine now, guys. So here also, what is there now, guys? Here also, every application having those three layers, right? Come on.
Yes, three.
Okay, service layer, presentation layer. After then, what? Service layer.
Data access layer, right?
So okay, yeah. Fine. Now, so here in the data access layer, what we are doing now? We are taking, based on the integration layer, we are taking that JSON data and we are converting that JSON data again. We are, if need, right? Then the data we are storing inside that what? We are storing that data inside what? Akash, your question is what? What is the difference between REST template and synchronous and asynchronous call is there, right? Okay, synchronous and asynchronous difference is there. In the web client, asynchronous call is storing and REST template is not, guys. Okay, so don't worry. Web client also I will explain. Okay, good question. If you put the question right, based on that question only, okay, I can also give the what? Pressure to my brain, right? Then I can think about that. The people are thinking like this also, right? So it's a good question, right? Good question. Okay, I will explain web client also. So fine. Okay, so REST template is there, right? REST template, fine. REST template, using the REST template, what we are doing now? Our REST template is right. Consumer is making the request and it's going to what? Our producer application. Based on that, if we are selecting the methodology, we are making the like get type request, then what will happen? Based on that get information, what will happen now in the REST consumer, right? REST producer, that method will execute and what? Response entity. It will return what? Response entity as what? Response to what? Consumer application, right? Consumer application. Sorry.
Very small doubt.
Yes.
Even in consumer application also, you have presentation layer, service layer, and data access layer.
Yes. Both application is different, guys. Okay. Both application is different. Everyone, producer application is what? Running in another server, and consumer is just think about that. This application is separate application, and this application is separate application, already is running in the server, right? In the different server, in the different programming language, and this application also different application, and what is that? It's running in the different server, but just think about that. This application is developed based on that what? .NET. This application is there on the .NET, right? .NET. Okay, and
yes,
we are
using the different technology.
And we are using the Java technology in this consumer application. Java technology they use to develop, to complete this project, right? But what will happen now? So
But just think about that our less business RK technology, just assume that our RK technology having is in this time less business, right? So the our separate business is going on. In the future, if our what RK technology is extended, right? So we have need some like supporter, different supporter, right? So currently we are developing what is that only this layer in our application. Normally these layers are there, right? In the future, if we want to extend our business with someone, right? Someone. So for that, what will happen now? And so I need what is that? This person, what is the services in our application also, right? In our application. So for that, what will happen now? But what is there? This application is developed on .NET. Then how we can how we can use this person services? So for that we have need to what is that, increase one more layer, right? Integration layer, na? Come on.
Yes, right.
Integration layer, right? Our integration layer, based on that, what we'll do now, we will trap this application data in integration layer. And what will happen now, this integration layer will interact with our service application. And after then what? This presentation layer is what? UI purpose. It will not interact. It will directly interact with service layer. And if need to store the data in what? Our consumer application in the database. Then our application will interact with database. And what will happen now? To store the data. Clear? So because of that, we have need what is that service layer, presentation layer. Every application based on this module only, right?
Yes,
correct.
It's not meaning that only what consumer CBOS, consumer some, like just think about that our right Paytm is there, right? Come on, Paytm is using so many people. Na, like what is that? Just think about that Paytm, if we are paying the money in what? Like mall also, there also we are using. We don't know na, what is the service provider bank about that mall?
Correct.
And just think about that every application. And what is that? Just think about that. Sometime we are watching the moving and we are online booking the ticket, right? Like Book My Show and all those things we are using. Nah?
Yes.
So Book My Show application is different.
Yes, they are giving option.
Yeah, but they are giving the option, right? Good, right? But still they are giving two options to use. What is that? Paytm, right? So Paytm will become what? Producer and what? Who is the consuming the Paytm services or Book My Show application, right? So, but still Book My Show application having all layers, guys. Okay. Every application having this common layer. But if need to interact our application with another application, then the picture will come to integration layer.
Yeah, got the floor.
Okay, fine now, guys. So REST template is a class given by Spring Boot REST API, guys. Okay, API. And by using this class, we cannot make as a HTTP call to producer application like get, post, put. Right, we have need to what explicitly give those information, URI information, this information, guys. Okay, URL information and method information, as well as what data information in what consumer. Then our consumer REST template will make the call, guys. Okay, then our REST template will make the call. And don't think about that our REST template will come auto configuration. No, this is the object, guys. We have need to explicit we have need to write explicitly, then we can work on this area. So now what I'm going to do now, just think about that. So here already our this application is completed, and just think about that, because here we have only one laptop, one computer, one machine. Now so in same machine, how we can develop two different applications? So what I'm going to do now, guys, just think about this application is there in Eclipse ID, what in the different workspace, and I'm going to develop this application
the port.
no I'm going to develop this application in different workspace, Now you guys will okay. get some feel. Okay. Yeah. Two application are there, and both application interacting with what each other. Ready, okay. everyone.
Yes. Ready.
Yes, Ravi.
Okay.
Ready yes. yes, Ravi. Ready, ready.
Good, 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 good. Okay, fine now, guys. So let's move on. Let's move on, and we will see that, guys. Okay. So okay, again, what we have need to do now, guys? What we have need to do now? So normally, what I'm going to do now? Just what is that? This application is there, na? Now, currently, I'm stopping this application. This project, right? This project, currently I'm stopping this project now, guys. Okay. So where? Yeah, this is right. So again, I'm going to open again another Eclipse ID, right? Another Eclipse ID. Okay, see this. Okay. Okay. Select another workspace. Okay, this workspace I'm selecting, right? Now launch it. Okay, now I'm deleting this one, this application, I'm deleting everything. I'm taking in this workspace freshly, guys, okay? I don't want to create confusion. Delete it.
Okay.
Okay, fine now, guys. So, okay. So to develop what consumer or consumer application, what is the dependency we need, guys? Okay, normally we will take what is that web. Web dependency, dev tool we will take. As well as what? Lombok, right?
Team leaf. Sorry.
No. REST template will come in the web dependency only.
Okay.
Lombok, these three dependency we will select, guys. Okay, okay, fine now, guys. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to create, we will work on a standalone application. Anyone is still remember our runner class? Whenever we are learning our core.
Yes, Ravi.
Boot core. Command line runner. Yes, very good.
Command line runner.
File, select file, new, and what? New Spring Startup. Spring Boot client application name is correct. Okay, no issue. Okay, fine. Okay, everything Java 8, select Java 8. Yeah, Java only. Next, select Lombok, Spring Dev Tool, and what? Spring Web. Fine now, guys. Next, yes. And finish. Some data is there na in the database. I want to check once. Yeah. Two records are there. No issue. Okay, fine. Okay, still project is
done.
No, it's still taking 75%. Yeah. Yes. Okay, fine now, guys. So now extract it. Come here, right? Now right click. New, take new. One. Yeah.
Class.
Dot just what is that?
Model.
Test app, right? So just here what's call all record. Right? Call yes, all record. Yes. This is the class. Okay, finish. Okay. Okay, our class is ready now, guys. Okay, fine now. So what we will do it now? So if you want, how our container will create the object of this class now, guys? What annotation we will apply on the top of this class? Very good. @component. @component. Fine. Good. So okay, so now okay, now one time, right? Implement, what is that? Implement command line runner. Okay, I'm taking
command line runner.
Good. So inside this one abstract method is there, which one will run based on that execution only, right?
Run method.
Yeah, fine. Okay, good. So fine now, guys. So what we will do it now, guys? Okay, fine. So here what I'm doing now, here I'm taking what? REST template RT equal to new REST template, right? REST template. Fine. Okay, good, guys. So fine. Okay, so we have need to select what? All record from the consumer application. Yes, come on. Okay, see this is the new. Yes, see this, guys, what is that? This is the another workspace, right? This is the another workspace where only one project is there. See this, only one project is there, right? And what? Yes. Our yes, consumer sir. Our consumer means what? Our producer is running in another workspace.
Different server. Yes.
Just assume it. Different. This application is running in different server, and assume this application is running in different server.
Yes. Yeah, sure.
Okay. Yes, so this is what? This is our consumer application, and what? This is our what? Just what? Just this is what? Our product application consumer. Is what? Producer application. Okay, so just what I'm going to do it now, guys. So here, this is the project management, right? This application, what I'm running this application, right click, run this application, and Spring Boot application now. I need to select what? I have need to what? Make the call of this method. I have need what? To make the call of this method. What is that? Save product, right? Save product is nothing but what?
Post,
right? So what we have need the inform we have need the information about this post method, na? Come on.
Yes.
Okay. So then what is the URI will become now? Controller, 1 minute, notepad. http://localhost localhost 9595
colon
95 slash